Hello and welcome, Ishani here, and today I have a very special video for all the special ladies in your life. We are making dress cards. The video says it's Mother's Day cards, but you know, you can make them for your teachers for Teacher's Day, for your girlfriend on Valentine's, or your daughters, or any special lady that you have in your life. Just customize it to probably the dress that she has. Let's see how we can make these cards. If you've been hoarding pattern paper like me, it's time to take them out. Here are some 6x6 pattern paper that I'll be using for my cards. But if you don't have pattern paper, you don't have to worry. You may use those pretty papers that you've kept from the wedding invitations or magazine covers. I always save such beautiful paper, and I'm still waiting for the rainy day when I'll use these. You could also make your own pattern paper by stamping some small images like these floral stamps and actually make a pattern similar to the dress of the recipient. And the options do not stop here. You could also use the gift wrappers that you may have. Or you could use those washi tapes that you love to not use. Finally, put them to use for dresses. Let's go ahead and use one 6x6 pattern paper. I've chosen this little floral print for a summer dress. I also take a yellow top folding note card, and I'm using double-sided strong tape that will help me adhere the pattern paper on the card base. But I'm leaving the top side, as I'm going to cut a neckline at that area, so I'm not applying any tape there. I like to use my stamping platform, as it gives me two edges on the adjacent sides to place the papers in a way that they are perfectly aligned when I'm adhering. And now that the paper is perfectly aligned and adhered, I'm going to cut off the excess of the pattern paper. For the neck of the summer dress, I want to cut out a little scallop circle, which will be the collar. And I'm going to use a die to cut out the neck from the upper part of my card, in a way that this collar fits the neck, and I die cut it off the camera. Now that I have the neck of the dress done, I'm going to adhere my scalloped collar with some glue. And I really like how classic this summer dress looks. And just to finish it off, I'm going to add a little brooch of a die-cut flower. It is not necessary that you use only this kind of die or flower. You could use a craft knife to cut out the neck pattern, or use some ready-made flowers to make your brooch, or add buttons to the dress with real buttons or half pearls. And if you have somebody who wears this kind of dress, please go ahead and make this and gift it to the special lady. Or you could do another card that I'm going to show you next for the lady who loves to wear some bling. Next card is a very simple card. I'll just quickly go through how I did it. I used a pretty pattern paper by Craft Angles, and I used a white colored card base. Cut out a piece of pattern paper that would fit the card and just leave some edges around. And then for the neckline, I've used a beautiful frame die with which I've cut the neck. And then I added some pretty bling that I have been holding for a long time. It is similar to a mirror sequin. And then I adhered it in a way that it looked like a blingy necklace. I hope you like this card and will try it with whatever you have in your house. Maybe you have those small pearls or some other sequins that you can make a necklace of. That was a quick and simple card made in just a few minutes. Also, let me share with you the cards that I made for Father's Day, which were shirt cards. If you're planning to make some, don't forget to watch my video on them that I'll link in the description below. And I would love if you'd subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, and let me know what would you like to learn next. My last card is the most special, and especially for those women who wear suits. I'm taking one of my prettiest pattern paper for this because I love such pattern for clothes myself. And you can use any card base, neutrals, or like I love to use pink, whatever you want. And I'm taking a top folding note card of Colombo cream. Basically, this cardstock is going to be hidden, so any color works. This cardstock Colombo cream is by Let's Craft, an Indian brand. And I cover the paper with my pattern paper, and I measure it and cut it so that it fits the card base. You could again use dies to make the necks, but for this card I'm going to use scissors and I'm going to make a V-neck for my kurta. Kurta and salwar together makes a suit, and it's quite a common dress in the South Asia, and the typical thing which is most prominent is a dupatta that is like a scarf taken on the shoulders, and I'm going to make the same. I measure so that my V is as centered as possible, and then I cut it with scissors. Now that my kurta is almost done, let's go ahead and add a dupatta. So I have saved this florist paper, also called woolly paper on Google. If you know the real name, please let me know in the comments below. So this paper came along with a bouquet, and like I save everything, I saved this, and today I thought I could use it as a dupatta. And it had perfect pleats already, which you can also make yourself. And I thought I can cut it in a way that it forms a dupatta on one of the sides of the shoulders of my kurta. Then I mark on the top because I need to tuck this dupatta into the paper, and it will not look nice if it has a bulge. So I cut off the extra pleats and keep my dupatta aside to fix it later. Let's do a little jewelry for my card first. Now I encountered a problem because I wanted to add this little pearl pendant with a thread. But now if I put the thread, it will be seen on the opposite side, for which now I need to change the cardstock of my neck, for which I have taken a lighter color cardstock. This is old lace cardstock, and I've cut a panel just to fit the neck behind my V-cut neck. I take double-sided tape and adhere my little piece of light-colored cardstock. I could have taken the same dark-colored cardstock, but then I thought this color looks better for skin. And then now is when I can add my little pendant, and the strings will also not be visible. So I take a strong glue and adhere my pearl first. I let it dry, and after it is dried, I take some scotch tape and adhere my strings behind the neck. And now is my little jewelry ready with the suit, and let's assemble the kurta. Next comes the dupatta, for which I need to use a stapler, as for this kind of a material like this paper is, the glue and tape, they do not work. So I tuck in my dupatta and use a stapler to staple it, just like how we use a pin. And you do not need this kind of paper. You could use crepe paper, net, some satin ribbon that you may have, any fabric that you have at your home. I'm sure you're one of those who do not, or maybe your mother does not throw things. I'm sure there is something there in your house that you can use. And then I take double-sided tape, which is very strong, and then adhere my kurta and dupatta on the card base. And I really love the way this suit card turned out, quite like a suit that I may have. I'm sure you have somebody in your life you can use this card for. You could use the inside to write a lovely message for your teacher or your mother, or maybe an aunt of yours. I hope you will try this card and the other ideas that I have shown. If you like them, please like this video, thumbs up, and also do not forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and happy Mother's Day to all the lovely mothers. Take care. Bye-bye.